What does a lifeguard need to know about methoxyflurane and malignant hyperthermia? Well, I think the key issue is that we ask patients whether they have a history or family history of malignant hyperthermia. That's a severe reaction to anaesthesia. If they have had that history, absolutely can't give methoxy. Methoxyflurane is a painkiller, but it's also, in the old days, it was an inhaled anaesthetic. Kind of thing you would get when they put you to sleep for surgery. As such, it has a weird ability to trigger something called malignant hyperthermia. That is a problem with your skeletal muscle where when you get triggered, and it could be from stress, infection, or methoxyflurane and other inhaled anesthetics, it triggers an out-of-control reaction where your skeletal muscle basically burns up and can't stop working. Your muscles get rigid. You can't breathe correctly, your jaw muscles spasm, all your extremity muscles spasm, and you begin burning up. You generate a tremendous amount of body heat, 41, 42, 43 degrees, even higher. Over time, minutes, you'll become unstable with high levels of carbon dioxide that you can't get rid of, low levels of oxygen, a very rapid heartbeat. Eventually, a low blood pressure as you begin to fade. That can happen within minutes. That could happen within an hour. It's typically an out-of-control process, and it's one that you won't be able to manage without help. This will be a call to 111. It'll be an ambulance trip into an ED and then an ICU. There's an antidote called dantrolene, but without that antidote, and without proper treatment, the fatality rate, the death rate, is 95%. So this is a tremendous illness. Now, if people know they have a family history of malignant hyperthermia, they will usually be aware of it, that their uncles or aunties had reactions with anesthetic. So that's what we're going to be asking everyone about. We also want to know whether they have any known allergies to any anesthetics themselves. That's a contraindication to getting methoxy. If they have kidney impairment or kidney disease, renal failure, kidney problems, they can't be on methoxy. If they've received methoxy within the past week, they shouldn't be given methoxy. And if they're intoxicated or unable to clearly follow commands, then their history is unreliable and they cannot get methoxy. And lastly, if they're already having difficulty breathing or they're hemodynamically unstable, that means that their oxygen levels are low, their heart rate is fast, their breathing is rapid, their blood pressure is low, any one of those things. If they are hemodynamically unstable, they shouldn't be getting methoxyflurane. So those